Hi everybody, this is Kim, and in this example I just want to show you the effectiveness of the method of the sequential quadratic programming when applied to medium-sized problems. It's a very wonderful technique. Let's compile this little program that I've made. Okay, and I'm gonna use a very well-known problem test example that is known in the literature as the Colville test. It consists in a complete cubic function, also with the square terms and all the cross products, subject to 10 constraints, the first two constraints greater or equal and the last 8 less or equal, and also we want non-negatives on the variables, so we have to add 5 constraints, as we know, and we are solving this problem using both techniques, the Lagrange-Newton equations combined with the active set strategy. I'm going to start in a very, very difficult point, the point 0,0,0,0,1, because this point become tied 6 constraints, as we got 5 variables. This is causing degeneracy on this starting solution. So I'm gonna put here 5 variables, 0 equality constraints, 1 greater or equal to, and 8 less or equal to constraints. Maximum number of iterations, let's put, I don't know, whatever, 50 for example. Let's do minimize. And the starting point, as I've said, is going to be the point 0,0,0,0,1. It's causing problems. Guess for the Lagrange multipliers, I like to start in the unitary vector. What I've done here is just removing the second constraint just to avoid this degeneracy, right? Let's do post in case the constraints. Now the less or equal to terms. Okay, 0 and 0, 2, 0, minus 0.4, minus 2, 3.5, 0, minus 2, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 4, 1, 0, 9, 2, minus 1, 2.8 and minus 2 0 4 0 0 1 1 1 1 1, and the last 1 2 3, and now decreasing 2 and 1, right hand side for the greater or equal 5, and for the rest 42, a quarter, 4 4 1 40, and 60. Okay, so in this point, in the 0,0,0,0,1, objective function being 20, maximum step length 1.74. And we got 2 values, x4 and x5, in the next iteration. The objective function decreases from 20 to 11.87. In the next iteration, the step length is 0.222, the maximum step length. And we got a new value on x3, x3 being 0.25, x4 being 0.443, and x5 being 0.496. And the objective, minus 18.98. Four. So look, from 11.87 we pass to minus 18. So the active set strategy is just wonderful, and the Lagrange-Newton equations are really good, because the improvements are really incredible. In the next point, okay, the step size 0.13, and we got a value also for the x2 variable being 0.38. x3 a quarter, x4 0.589, and x5 0.225. The objective function minus 26. Another iteration. Step length maximum 4.80, and as it is greater than 1, we keep 1. This gives us a new point, 0.45 for x2, a quarter for x3, 0.75 for x4, and 0.063 for x5. The objective function, minus 25. And in the next iteration, the maximum step length 0.3, and the point is 0.003. Now we got five values for the overall vector of the variables of decision, the x's, and the objective function minus 31.98. This is the solution, by the way. So this is in fact the solution. So in only 6 iterations we have solved this problem with a very problematic starting point. So as you can see, the first constraint is tight, the fourth and the sixth and the seventh constraints are tight, the rest are loose, and the Lagrange multipliers as the program is convex over our feasibility region, Lagrange multiplier is positive of 0.00719, 5.34, 2.65, and 12.005. So that's the solution of the problem, the Colville test. A very good problem. And with this, I finish. I hope you have enjoyed, as always, and have a nice day. Bye bye.